Hi, everybody. I'm Peter Travers, and welcome to a special edition of Popcorn where we discuss the best and worst movies of the year. So I'm going to do a countdown on the best. And I'm going to say number five is The Life of Pi. If this is a movie you haven't seen in a theater in 3D, do it while the holiday season is still on, because it's a great story, a great fable. Ang Lee does a terrific job as a director. You're going to be amazed at this. Number four is Silver Linings Playbook, a movie that I think will get nominations for Jennifer Lawrence, Bradley Cooper, Robert De Niro, about kind of mentally challenged people who fall in love. Don't let anybody tell you anything more about it, because there's a lot of surprises in it. Number three, Lincoln, Steven Spielberg's epic, which people are screaming should win every kind of Academy Award, starting with Daniel Day-Lewis, who plays Lincoln. And according to rumor, more than rumor, even reporting, he never came out of character. He was Lincoln 24/7. Well, it seems strange, but it pays off when you see this movie. Number two movie of the year is Zero Dark Thirty. This is Catherine Bigelow's follow-up to The Hurt Locker, in which she deals with the hunt for Osama bin Laden, seen through the eyes of a CIA agent played by Jessica Chastain, played brilliantly by Jessica Chastain. Here's suspense, here's truth, here's everything you want a movie to be, none of the usual Hollywood bull. And number one, I'm choosing The Master, Paul Thomas Anderson's movie that I know. People can throw things at me, they can be angry, people that see this and don't like it, really don't like it, and threaten me on the street. And I say you people are wrong. Go watch Joaquin Phoenix give this incredible performance of his career, even though he seems to be going a little nuts and screaming at people about, I don't want Oscars, they're all bull. Philip Seymour Hoffman as the master, Amy Adams as the master's wife. Everybody in this movie is doing something extraordinary. So I'm going with the year's most divisive movie as the best picture of 2012. You know, you can't talk about a movie year without talking about the movies that made the money. What were the box office hits? And the biggest box office hit is The Avengers. The Avengers was actually, I think, a good piece of pop escapism. It wouldn't be on my 10 best list anywhere, but it nonetheless brought together all those Marvel superheroes as one. And I think Robert Downey Jr. as Iron Man. And to see what Mark Ruffalo does with the Incredible Hulk was really a kick. Joss Whedon is a guy who knows his way around this kind of a movie. Then there's a movie called Ted, which was with Mark Wahlberg and a dirty talking teddy bear, which became everybody's favorite comedy for 2012. And you know what? I know it's not great, but I laughed. I laughed through this whole thing. And number three, I think would be not only a commercial hit, but a one that you'll see on people's 10 best list and also see when awards get out, and that would be Christopher Nolan's The Dark Knight Rises. This is the end of the Batman trilogy. It's not as good as the one previous with Heath Ledger, because Heath Ledger was doing something as the Joker that just raised the level of that. But still, Nolan made a commercial pop movie into something approaching art. And so I'm amazed that a movie that was commercial was also artful, and that the audience embraced what the critics embraced. My favorite thing to talk about in a movie year is the garbage. What was the crap that was out there? There was so much. I could sit here for an hour and do 100 movies, but I'm not gonna do that. I am just gonna pick on three horrendous ones. Number three, Cloud Atlas. What was going on? They've got Tom Hanks, they've got Halle Berry, they've got the Wachowskis, the Matrix people. This movie didn't make a lick of sense. There wasn't a moment of sanity in it, bad accents. Oh, God, I just hated it with a vengeance. I'm sorry, that's just the way it was about Cloud Atlas. If you feel differently, you know, live with yourself, because you can't live with me. I just couldn't do it. Number two for bad, Twilight. Twilight Breaking Dawn, part two, part forever, the final chapter. It couldn't come soon enough for me. Please, how is this so successful? Kristen Stewart, Rob Pattinson, their own off-screen drama where they broke up for a while was more dramatic than anything in this pathetic movie with the worst special effects. They're kind of vegan vampires. They don't do anything. Why are you people interested in this? Blech! Okay. Number one, worst movie of 2012 has to be Battleship. Battleship is a movie that seems like it was directed by Michael Bay, who did me a favor and didn't make a movie in 2012, but he forced Peter Berg, usually a good director, to come in and make this horrible movie out of a game that made no sense with the worst acting ever, ever in the world. And if you should see this, or somebody says, let's watch Battleship Tonight on Netflix, you tell those people that they are not your friend and say the word Battleship only when you go, it's horrible. It is horrible. And I am Peter Travers.